Dana, we just might have witnessed one of the greatest light heavyweight title fights in UFC history. Who did you score it for?
It was awesome. I got really into the fight, and I didn't score it. You know, obviously on the way out, I was talking to people, and some people are saying, I had it 3-2, Gustafsson. I had it this, that. I talked to Mark Ratner. Mark Ratner had it even going into the last round, and he gave the last round to Jones. So I got to watch it on TV and score it. But I want to say this. The other day, came here and did the scrum. I had to do an interview with Ariel Helwani and listen to him say, Dana, listen, you know, me and four guys on the internet think that the promotion of this fight has been very weird. And I'm like, weird how, Ariel? What does that even mean? He said, well, you know, you're trying to make it sound like it's all about height and reach and things like that. And we just think that's really goofy. Really? When has a fight never been about height and reach? And obviously this fight tonight was all about height and reach.
For the record, if I may.
Oh, yeah, please.
I never said that I disagreed with it. In fact, for the record, I actually thought it was a very smart way because you were promoting tactics as opposed to just this guy's going to stand and trade. What I was talking about was pride of a nation. Ingemar Johansson, Floyd Patterson, Sweden, all that stuff.
So in Sweden, they would have cared about that, but the rest of the world, they wouldn't, because the reality about this fight was everybody's always had problems with John Jones' height and reach, and this guy matched him in height and reach, or as close as anybody's ever going to get. And tonight, it was a huge factor in this fight.
That being said, were you expecting it to go down like that? Five-round war, that he was able to take those shots.
Not only did I not expect it to go five rounds, I never thought that Gustafsson would be able to stop John Jones' takedown. I thought that was going to be his weakness in this thing. I thought he would probably outstrike Jones, then Jones would take him down and try to ground and pound him. And that never happened. It was actually the actual opposite. Gustafsson took him down.
First time ever in Jones' career. Is this one of those fights that even though Jones kind of squeaked by, he's looked superhuman, that almost, you know, thus far in his career, no one has really tested him, that now people will respect him more because he was able to survive?
Yeah, I mean, the guy's got an incredible chin. The guy's got unbelievably unorthodox striking where he can spin with those elbows. Then Gustafsson came back with one of those, too. It was an amazing fight. It was a great night. And I know that Gustafsson is hurting right now, him and his camp, but, you know, it's one of those fights that you don't lose anything.
Obviously, it was a loss, but his stock has to be up now, right, Alex?
His stock is way up. Unbelievable fight. The place was going crazy. I mean, it was unbelievable.
As of right now, we haven't talked to John. We hear he's hurting. Is there any update on how he's feeling?
John, they took John out of the octagon and took him straight to the hospital.
He won't be talking to the media. What's wrong with him, just overall?
Yeah, I mean, he was in an absolute war. He's got a massive cut. I don't know if you heard, but the doctors were going to stop the fight in the last round.
Really?
Because of the cut.
Going into the last round?
Yeah, and Jones begged them not to stop the fight. And from what I understand, McCarthy did too, pleaded them not to stop the fight.
Such a close fight. I know you're on Twitter and listening to the fans. A lot of fans thought Alex won.
Yeah.
Is there a chance? I know it's rare when the champion retains, you do an immediate rematch. Is there a chance you do this again right away?
Yeah, there's a real good possibility we could do this again.
What do you do with Glover then?
We give Glover another fight.
Is that what you're leaning towards right now?
I'm not. Literally, I hadn't even thought about it till you just said it.
But you like the idea.
I like the idea. I think that fight was awesome. I think this is one of those fights that people would love to see again. And, yeah, and it'd be hard for either one of the fighters not to think they both should rematch.
Obviously, John is the champion, but would you consider doing this in Sweden? That could be one of the biggest events ever in that country's history.
I haven't even considered it at all, so I haven't thought of where it would be either. So I don't know.
Did you have a chance to talk to John after the fight?
I didn't. You know, I just shook his hand. That's it.
What about Alex?
I shook his hand and talked to him for a minute. I said, kid, you lose nothing in this fight. You know, I know it sucks that you lost, and you're not walking out of here with that belt, but like you said, stock is through the roof.
Let's talk about the co-main event. Henan Burrell, really, he cemented his place as not only the interim champion, but maybe the best bantamweight right now. Does that fight have to happen? Do you almost wait now for Dominic to come back because that would be so huge?
Yeah, it's a big fight. And the kid is so unbelievably amazing. He just, I don't even have words for that kid. He hasn't lost in over 8 years, 21 fights in a row. It's just, wow.
Is there an official deadline in place? Dominic has to be ready by this time, unless, you know, he's not, you got to strip him something.
He told us he would be ready by the first of the year, you know, the beginning of the year. So, yeah, if he's not ready by the first half of the year, then we're going to have to do it.
do you wind down from something like this? How do you, what do you do? This is one of the greatest fights ever, right?
It was a great fight, and it's not that I need to wind down. I'm so happy that it went this way, because I'm much worse when they're bad.
Very well said. Congratulations on a great show for the company, and once again, I think I speak for a lot of people. A rematch might be in order.
Thank you. I don't disagree.